Praise be to Allah. We praise Him and we seek His help and forgiveness. Brothers, we all feel touched when we open up a good translation of the meaning of the Quran. And we ponder and wonder at the purity of the words and the deep meaning within. But in reality, we are just seeing a glimpse of the real treasure that Quran is. Imagine how you would feel if you could understand the words of Allah in the form in which they were sent down, and not just rely on translation of the meaning in English. Imagine the power of the words and the directness of the message then. The potency will be great. The Quran is the word of Allah and the direct message from Allah to us, His creation. And Allah chose the Arabic language as the language of this message. Indeed, Allah tells us this in the Quran, emphasizing to us that to understand the message completely, one must understand the language. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, indeed, we have sent it down as an Arabic Quran in order that you may understand. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we have inspired to you an Arabic Quran so that you may warn the mother of the towns and all around it. Arabic and the message of Quran cannot be separated. And translators through the ages have tried to convey to non-Arabic speaking people the beauty of the meaning of the Quran, but have always called it the translation of the meaning of the Quran, emphasizing the fact that the Quran's direct translation is impossible, because so much of the potency and the splendor of the words and their meanings are lost in English and or any other language. Remember that for the Arabs, in the time the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, who were the master of the eloquence and poetry, the words of Quran itself were so unique compared to the poetry of the most eloquent of them, that many came to Islam, recognized that Quran could not be the handiwork of even the best human poet. Rather, it could only come from Allah. The language itself was one of the miracles of Quran, and Allah challenges mankind, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and if you are in doubt about what we have sent down to our servant, then produce a chapter like it and call your witnesses beside Allah if you are truthful. But if you don't do it and you can never do it, then fear the fire whose fuel is men and the stones prepared for the disbelievers. The preservation of Arabic language. Language usually evolves. Just look at the difference between Shakespeare's English and today English. In many ways, they seem like two totally different languages. And a man from England in the time of Shakespeare's, and a man from today who speak English would find it difficult, extremely difficult to communicate. But the Arabic language is not just a language. This is why the Sahaba, the companion of the Prophet, peace be upon him, and the early generation of Muslims strove to preserve the classical Arabic language. The classical Arabic language. It was Ali, radiallahu anhu, who noticed on the tongues of some Arabs a slight change in dialect, and ordered for the grammar rules of Arabic to be recorded in universal form. He knew that the preservation of the Arabic language was part of the preservation of Islam itself. Arabic unified the Muslim countries as it spread to every land that embraced Islam. This is why it seemed to those Muslim societies that they are ignorant of Arabic, are in general less knowledgeable about Islam. The enemies of Islam know this and have worked hard to tear the Muslims from Arabic language and the Quran during the French occupation of Algeria. The French government was advised to stop people from learning Quran and Arabic. And unfortunately, this is exactly what the leader of Turkey, Kemal Atatürk, did. He ordered that the Quran to be recited in Turkish, even in prayer, and changed the Turkish language, which used to be written in Arabic, into Latin.